For full episodes of the Diverse Mentality podcast, check the links in the description below. The full video version is available on the main channel, and the audio version is available on your favorite streaming platforms such as Spotify, Apple Podcasts, and more. Next, and I wanted to talk about this because I like giving Lil Baby praise, and I think he right now is the best for the new generation. But Fat Joe says no one in this generation is better than Lil Baby, in their generation, by the way, Lil Baby's generation. So I don't know what the time frame for that is. You could say 2017 till now. But you'd be pressed to argue that. Like, it would be pretty hard to argue an artist right now that is doing better than Lil Baby. Let's play that clip. I'm trying to pull it up right here. Because it's facts, man. There's nobody right now from 2017 and up. I'll set that time frame because they didn't set the time frame for it. But for me personally, it's 2017 and up. That's the time frame for me. And I think that makes sense. What artist can you name 2017 and up that's bigger than Lil Baby right now? I can't think of any off the top of my head. Okay, let me play this.
The newer generation, they're embracing the money anthems.
Generation, there's nobody better than Lil Baby right now.
He's on fire.
There's nobody better than him. We've seen all this. We as hip-hop historians,
yes.
We saw when Lil Wayne emerged. We saw when Eminem emerged. And Lil Baby's in the lane by himself right now. Mm. It's sad because the other night I'm with Khaled. We in Khaled's convertible Maybach. And he played 3 records in there.
Yeah.
And they were 3 of the biggest artists that of the time.
Yeah.
And he played one guy that's been winning for like 10 years straight. He played one guy, he played this group, then he played that Lil Baby, and it sounded like this guy's the best.
Wow.
Right now. So I'm gonna have to go with Lil Baby and 42 Doug.
And I know some people are like, yo, Lil Baby gang got bars. Nah, man, you gotta listen. I always say this, listen. Don't count Lil Baby out like he ain't shit. I agree with him, man. If we're counting who is the hottest overall, too, right now Lil Baby's the most consistent, man. He's actually surpassing Drake in consistency. I think Drake he takes like breaks, but Lil Baby's been doing a lot of features. Every you could say almost every album hip hop that's major that's come out has a Lil Baby feature on it. J. Cole, I think Migos have him on his album. I don't know if Migos did. But I know, I think Polo G did. I don't know. Maybe Polo G and Migos didn't. I don't remember. But lots of people have featured him on his album. And he's, to be honest with you, he's killing like every feature that I can think of. Like, if you put Lil Baby with somebody, 9 times out of 10, Lil Baby's beating them when it comes to that feature, like that verse. So, yeah, I can't think. If you guys can think of anything from 2017 and up that's bigger than Lil Baby, let me know. Because like Fat Joe was saying, you can tell when there's runs. Like when Eminem had his run, when 50 had his run, when Lil Wayne, Kanye West. Like you can tell they're that it person. And it's just them. That's what I mean. Like that's what I hate to bring this up again. That's what I mean with dominance. Like Jay-Z was never dominant. Like he was never that it person. In my eyes, at least. I never, like, you never looked at, like, a span of years and say, that was just Jay-Z, period. Sorry to go back on that, but definitely Lil Baby. Like, you can look right now at this time and be like, it's Lil Baby's year. He's dominating in sales, dominating in features. It's reminding me 100% of Lil Wayne's run because Lil Wayne was doing a lot of features. Eminem and 50 weren't really doing features like that. They were doing in-camp features, and if they were doing outside features, it was, like, rare moments. But Lil Baby's run is reminding me of Lil Wayne's. And right now, you could say it's Lil Baby's year. You could have argued it was Pop Smoke, too, because he was heating up. And obviously, in 2020, both their albums were really close in sales. But you could also, you know, point to, like, him passing away, you know, posthumous release. It helped boost sales, maybe. But his album was amazing, Pop Smoke's debut album. So, yeah, I want to see what you guys think about that. I can't really think of anything else that anybody from 2017 up that's bigger than Lil Baby right now.